Welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get into the OVO sound. Now we're going to dig into the R&B style of the sound and really just kind of bring out our own expression of that brand. So that brand is like the modern day R&B, very elongated chords, you know, very spaced out drums to where the drums aren't taking over the beat. You know, it's very gappy. It's very melodic and very reverb heavy. So that's kind of the brand of that sound. So let's open up something where we can start producing chords. Let's just open up a general sound. Now let me think, what instrument can we use to start off with? Let me think here. I'm trying to think if we want to go the synth route or if we want to go, let's just go FL keys. Now we're not going to keep it on FL keys. I'm using this to generate a tone. Then we're going to switch out the instrument later. So the first step is to turn on your metronome, okay? And you want to have a nice BPM like 120. We're going to produce in double time, which means it's going to sound like the song is at half the BPM. So it's going to sound like it's at 60 BPM, but we're producing in 120 BPM. Okay, so that's kind of it's called contrast. Okay, so let's right click, open up piano, and let's start with a nice major 7 chord, and let's transpose it to get different feels for the same chord. So I'm using my chord codes, which we go over for free at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. You can even get a free chord code book after watching the video on how to use them. So here we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the major chord code. To make it a major 7th, we're going to add an 11, which means the number 11, not an 11th, which is a scale degree. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So this is where we're going to start. And I'm just going to play 2 chords. So it's going to go da, da. So I'm just going to copy this and move it up so that I'm listening to these top notes. So this is another major 7 chord code. Now it doesn't sound proper to me. It feels like it's not the right tone. So we're going to make this a minor 7th. And that feels a little bit better. Now we're going to copy the same exact chords and we're going to change something about it. So I'm going to move up that second note up an octave. That makes it a little too happy. So what I'm going to do is actually take the top note. That's too much. Let's do second to highest note. Bring it down an octave. Okay, so we're keeping it kind of dark by pulling it down instead of going up. Now we can switch out the actual instrument. So now let's program our own sound. Let's use Silenth, since this is a plugin we can all use. And let's go to a sine wave. Let's turn the polyphony up. Put the portamento on. This is one of the keys here. Turn the portamento on. And also put it on slide mode so that the notes glide from one note to the next. I like to turn my portamento way up for this style. So now it's just a matter of filtering out the sound. Let's add a low pass filter and then turn up the resonance to add that hollowed effect. You can add even a little distortion. Spice it up a bit. Actually, this distortion is pretty aggressive. So let's turn up the cutoff filter and let's run it through a reverb in the mixer. Let's open up Fruity Reverb 2. Turn the wet level up. Widen out the stereo spread. So now we have a stereo image versus a mono signal. Turn up the decay time a bit. And this is where the extra tone comes from. A lot of people think it's in sound design. It's actually in the mixing process. The reverb is a sound in itself. You know, you have to think of it like an extra tone. Now we can add a little more bass in the reverb just to add more of a dark coloration to the sound. I'm going to lower the wet level just a bit and cut out a little bit of the lows so we're not getting too muddy down in the low frequencies. Now for this sound, I'm going to give it a little attack so it doesn't come in as a kind of a plucky type of sound. Give it a little release. So it kind of blurs the lines between the chords. Like I said, you can always lower the cutoff filter. As long as you have your resonance up, it creates that hollowed sound. Now, if you want to texturize this, you would add a compressor or some kind of thing after the reverb. So in this case, I'm going to add an 1176 emulation from Native Instruments. This is a compressor known for a specific type of sound. I'm going to put it on all mode, which is all the buttons squashed in. Kind of cut back. Give it a fast attack, fast release. Now the thing here, I don't like all mode. Let's put it on 20:1 ratio. Here it gives it a little crunch, but let's open up that release to get rid of that crunch sound. This compressor just evens out the tone of the reverb. Okay, so we're just flattening that tone out. Now let's get into adding drums. Let's go to our browser. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's go to our big drums. We use this in another OVO style beat session. It was called Drake Views from the Sixth Session. And that was a non-audio video, but now let's go into the kicks. I'm going to use what seems like a big kick, but we're actually going to process it so it sounds a little bit different. Let's go to snares. I'm going to use the dirty snare, and let's try another snap just to kind of layer it. And even a snare clap just to kind of, you know, have options here. Now, hi-hats aren't the thing for this kind of R&B style, so we're going to stay away from hi-hats, depending on which sound we're talking about. But for the most part, aren't too many hi-hats in this genre. Now that we have the mood, which is the chord progression, now we can add our own tone. Now, one thing you want to check is change the key of the song. So with the chords here, it's going to maintain the same mood, but we can change the tone of the sound. So all we have to do is hit Control A, shift up or down to change the key. And this way you can hear the chord progression in a different key, and it gives you a different vibe. It might inspire you differently. Pull this up again. That one just doesn't sound right. To me, this gives me a nice metallic sound at the top. I know metallic is a little abstract of a term. But I like this tone a little bit more than before. Let's go to pattern two. Send these to the mixer and let's start writing out the drum pattern. Now again, it comes down to that chord progression. It comes down to the way you add in the bass. So let's program our own bass. We're not going to use any samples. We could use an 808. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com, load up an 808 from the 808 Science drums, load up convex, change it up a bit from the concave, and let's turn or carbon, 808 carbon, which I like to use a lot because it works, you know. Anyway, let's use convex. And what was I gonna do here? We're gonna have to write out the drum pattern, and then we're gonna filter the drums later. So let's write it out so it sounds heavy now, it sounds high pitched now, but when we filter it and kind of work on it, again, your kicks and snares are gonna be very separated. It's not gonna be a hip hop pattern. We're going to clone this pattern, add snaps instead of the dark snare. Now the snare clap seems a little too hard for this, so I'm going to leave it out for now. Now for that darker snare, I feel like the kick needs a little more activity. Like boom, dum, boom, dum, boom, dum. So we're gonna add a little more activity. But for that snap, we can space it out a bit more, and I'll show you how to fill in the gaps with the snap. So let's open up Fruity Reverb 2, and let's add that to the snap. We're gonna widen out the stereo, give it a long decay time. That's gonna fill in all the gaps. It's gonna add a nice long tail to that snap sound. Okay, it's gonna give it a nice wall of sound. Kick to me needs to be pitched, it needs to be tuned. It wants to go boom. It's going duh. It needs to go boom. So I'm going to pull that pitch down. And the snare is going, it needs to go. Okay, so let's pull that pitch down as well. Remember, we pulled the pitch down. Oh, no, we didn't. Never mind. I'm referencing something else. Kick kind of dies out, we can add that 808 to fill in the gaps. So that's the contrast there. We have the kick heavy with the dark snare, and then when it's a little bit lighter weight, we can have a nice spectrum contrast with the higher frequency snap and that really low frequency 808. Let's go to pattern 4. Let's find the key of this 808 sample. Let's right click, go to edit, go to your detect pitch regions. Now you can do this many different ways. We have a video on how to tune your instruments in any DAW. You want to look it up on our YouTube channel. So this says G sharp, so that means the 808 was tuned to G sharp. Let's go to our envelope now. Reset the root note, and you want to right click on G sharp so that it's tuned to the keyboard. So when I play notes, it will actually play the right note. And here's where we can add our own little 808 rhythm. So first start with the rhythm, then dig into the notes. So let's right click in that. Let's go to piano roll. Now let's give it a note value. Let's hit control up. I like to hear it in a higher octave so I know what it sounds like. Then we can lower the pitch. Then I want to lower these down to the note B. So these are the notes I want. For the next section, we're going to change up the notes, but let's hit control down to transpose that down an octave or two. Let's make the second half unique. Then I'm gonna go doom, boom, boom, boom. So let's figure out that tone. So we're at A, something, something. Dun, 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 dun. So A, B, E. Okay, that's just what my ear wants, and that's what I'm gonna give my ear. Okay, you gotta listen to the notes that are playing in your head. I say it all the time, there are songs playing out in your head. You're just not translating that idea. And it leads to what's called writer's block, because you're not recording those ideas into audio form. Anyway, let's transpose that down an octave. Let's add another section with the snap. One thing to check is the tuning of the synth. I'm going to pull it down. It feels a little sharp. Now, I like to do this with the range of 1 so that I don't change the key by accident. Because the tonal thing I'm listening to is the 808. And the 808 is not perfectly tuned to 440 Hz middle A. I didn't take that step to really tune it. So one thing you could do is pitch down or pitch up your main synths, or just deal with your 808 individually. So I pitched it down about 14 cents so that the notes can match a bit better. Let's add that dirty. So let's filter the kick. So right now the kick has all the frequencies. to actually muffle the sound by adding a low pass filter, pulling up on the resonance of the cutoff filter point. Keep getting tongue twisted because my ideas are flowing. So let's lower that low pass filter, add a little bit of resonance to add tone. Same with the snare. It's already filtered, but we're gonna add more of a low pass filter sound. Let's go back a bit. And one thing you can experiment with is adding decimort. You can lower the bit rate of the sound, but this one you gotta be careful because it kind of makes the sound more pulse wavy. So you gotta be careful here. Has a built-in low-pass filter, which I like. So I like to experiment with it. For this sound, it's just not the right fit. So instead of the 808, let's build out a Moog bass, which is going to serve as the bass line. Okay, so let's open up Silenth 1. I'm going to show you how to build a Moog bass style in Silenth 1. It's a little bit different of a sound design approach. So in this Silenth patch, be sure to copy your value for the pitch that you have on the other Silenth so that you're writing in the same key. Paste that in. Now I'm going to use one voice of a saw on the left, one voice of a saw on the right. So right now, you can hear the phase issues. Well, I'm gonna detune one of the voices from the other. So I'm gonna pull that, fine tune it. So now it has more of a two voice feel. That's how you create a nice Moogish sound right inside of Silenth. Now you could change the waveform as well. I suggest using the sawtooth, but you could always use a lower octave pulse. Let's add a low-pass filter to get rid of some of that high end. Add resonance, of course. Let's add mono legato and portamento. Okay, now I like to create my own stereo by adding another layer, layer B. Let's copy the filter, paste it into layer B. Turn this on to whatever sound waves you want. It could be a sawtooth, it could be a sine wave, pulse wave, triangle wave, whatever you want. Let's turn it to a triangle. I'm going to pan the sawtooth to the left, pan the triangle to the right. So that creates its own stereo. I don't have to, you know, add multiple voices. Now to detune these. And it creates its own unique kind of retro sound. Figure out a nice bass line. I like the hold notes for the bass. Now let me make sure some of this. Okay, I was making sure the polyphony was up on the silent. Let's drop this down an octave. I want to go boom, boom. Then I want to go dun. And it's going to copy that same note length. The wrong note. Let's open up the filter on the pad a bit. Now remember, we're in double time, so this is what, let's see, looks like I can't count 13 to 29 to 16. So we can double that. And then the second half, let's get rid of the regular drums. Let's add those snap drums. And that can be the variation. So I've seen a lot of questions. How do you create variations? How do you create transitions? You know, it's based on how you arrange your song. What are the elements? You have to have enough elements to omit. That was one of the super producer qualities and traits, is that they have enough elements in the song to where they can take some away and still have a song. And if you can't do that, that means you need to add either more elements or you need to expand musically. Or you're just not thinking of what the vocalist could do solo or whatever section they're in. So that's what songwriting comes down to. I mean, there's a lot to it, but that's the primary cause of most problems I see. Let's add a little more character to the sound. I'm going to add a little vibrato to the pad by giving the pitch value here in the LFO1 a very small amount, 0.1, turning the gain up a very small amount, turning it on free mode, and giving it its own hertz value, so its own frequency. Now if I crank this up, it's going to be obvious, but I'm going to make it less obvious and more subtle. Okay, so that will kind of blur the pad out a bit. Now if you want to change keys quickly without going into the MIDI, you can pull down your master pitch or pull it up. I like to pull it up first. Compressor's even adding artifacts. Let me make sure it's not from the... Yeah, it's even adding a little bit of artifacts, so it sounds like it's sampled. So these are the little things about mixing which make your song... take your song to the next level. You hear that kind of vinyl pop if I solo the sound? It's really the character of the compressor. Almost distorting the sound a bit. I like this pitch a little bit more. Where are we at? I don't even know. We're at plus 400. So what that means is we need to go to each channel and pull everything up 4 semitones. So I'm just going to hit shift up 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. There, the chord progression's raised up 4 intervals, and let's go to our bass line, our other musical element, pull it up 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I like the sound a little bit better. So that's why you can experiment with keys. It's the same mood, it's just a different tone. Also, the 808 needs to be... almost forgot. 808 needs to be pitched up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same with pattern 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Out the sound for different bands. Let's pull the subs in mono, but pull out the low mids a bit more. Widen those out. Let's hear what the bass and the 808 do. Now, I've seen this way too many times. producers adding way too many bass elements in a track. I literally just got done with a mix order that had four bass elements in it, and I've seen this twice so far in the last month or two. Four bass elements. You can't have that many bass elements playing all at once. There's going to be major problems when it comes to mixing. So some people want to stack an 808 on the bass. Well, you have to understand there's a consequence to that when it comes into the mixing stage. If you want these project files, you want to go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. You want to sign up with your email. Be sure to confirm your email in order to get the downloads. Thank you for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.